While some consider that there should be a minimum age for piercing a child's ears, others see no objection to this practice. So, the question of putting holes in a baby's ears is not always unanimous. How do you know if he's the right age? What are the risks to be aware of? What about the care required if you decide to take the plunge? Find out all the answers in this video. Many people pierce their baby's ears during the first few months. However, this subject can be the subject of controversy because several factors come into play in this decision. Some simply refuse to do so and only consider this act if the child asks for it. However, this gesture is not trivial and must meet certain conditions to preserve the health of the youngest. Arnault Pfersdorff, pediatrician in Strasbourg, reveals the things to know about this subject. What is the minimum age to pierce a child's ears? To respond to certain traditions, for aesthetic reasons or simply by parental choice, some choose to pierce their baby's ears a few months after birth. However, this intervention should be avoided when the latter is still very young, according to Dr. Pfersdorff. A baby will explore his body from the age of 4 to 5 months, says the specialist. A phase when it is difficult to control his gestures and where he will tend to touch his ears. The risk of infection is also present, since at a young age, the child can tear off the earring. His advice? Wait 18 or even 24 months. This is the correct age, at the earliest, to do the piercing. Asked about this, Catherine Salinier, former president of the French Association of Ambulatory Pediatrics, explains that the French recommendations in this area do not define a particular age. Thus, parents must be kept informed of the risks involved but remain free to decide. What must be avoided is coercion in the child. What is not good is doing something to him, and then forbidding him to touch his ears, explains Drive Pfersdorff. The latter must understand what awaits him, with simple words adapted to his age. It also helps maintain the relationship of trust that binds him to his parents. Ideally, therefore, it is best to wait until the child is able to understand that he should not touch his pierced ears. The doctor even gives his personal opinion and explains that it is better to wait until the latter formulates the request, especially in adolescence. It's his body, we let him think, we can accompany him. But to pierce the ears of a very small baby, that always raises a little question, notes the expert. Indeed, the pediatrician Arnault Fernandez considers that we speak rather of breaking the skin barrier in the event of a piercing and that it is imperative to wait 24 months before piercing the ears of a child. What are the risks of ear piercing? For Dr. Salinier, the risks are the same, regardless of age. There are no more risks, nor are there less, if the child is 6 months or 3 years old, she explains. First of all, you should know that it is a pain that the baby feels in the same way as an adult. Then, there are three risks to know according to the specialist. Tearing off the earring, which can lead to trauma. A skin allergy, especially to nickel, on contact with the jewel. An infection because the child can touch bacteria and then touch their ear. An opinion joined by Dr. Pfersdorff, who also adds that when the child is too young, the risk of ingestion following the tearing of the earring exists. In addition, the material of the jewel can be responsible for contact eczema and increase the risk of superinfection. Local antibiotic treatment will then be necessary, but these cases remain relatively rare when hygienic conditions are respected. What precautions should you take if you decide to pierce a child's ears anyway? First of all, you have to choose a jeweler and verify that the latter works with sterile and disposable equipment. It must be done under conditions of maximum asepsis, warns the pediatrician. The piercer must also be a certified professional, use gloves, have good hygiene and an exclusive room for this practice. An opinion joined by his colleague who explains that for parents who want to pierce the earlobes of their children, it is imperative that the store has two separate spaces to limit the risk of infection. Note that it is also possible to go to an ENT doctor capable of performing the piercing. What happens after ear piercing? Since the earlobe contains several blood vessels, complete disinfection of the wound is essential, while being very careful not to create lesions or catch the jewelry. Arnault Pfersdorff advises using an antiseptic cleanser after the procedure and then using soap when the scab disappears to clean the loop and ear. Healing usually takes a few weeks, with the placement of a temporary piece of jewelry at the start. When the skin has healed, it is best to opt for a pair of small earrings to limit the risk of snagging. Dr. Fernandez also calls for caution in the days following the piercing. You have to be very careful about the follow-up of the piercing. In the event of tingling, redness, swelling, pain or discharge, the equipment must be immediately removed and a specialist should be consulted urgently, specifies the doctor. He also emphasizes that those who are thinking about opting for earrings with magnets should be careful. And for good reason, the latter do not become infected but can end up being inhaled due to their small size. It is better to wait for the child to request it. Ideally, this is the preferred option. For Dr. Selenier, what affects the physique of the child first requires his agreement, when he is old enough to speak on this subject. It also refers to the scar that can mark the skin after the hole has closed. As a doctor, I am not in favor of it because it is not a medical practice. This gesture is neither trivial nor essential, she reveals. An opinion shared by Arnault Pfersdorff, who also emphasizes that it is necessary to see if the child really wants to have his ears pierced before giving the green light as a parent. According to him, it is around 9 to 10 years that this request can really be formulated. But this is not enough. For the pediatrician, it is necessary to be attentive, to hear the wishes of the child but not to rush. To give his agreement, wait and see if he will ask it several times, ask him why he wants to do it, advises the specialist. Indeed, it happens that the children emit requests to behave, like their friends, explains the doctor. In this sense, it is better to take your time, listen to the teenager's arguments without issuing a prohibition, and then think about it before giving your answer. Piercing baby's ears. What are the health risks? The cause: high risk of skin infection, up to 1 in 5 children, and the spread of germs. Indeed, the microbes seize this opportunity to infiltrate the body of the child, recalls Arnault Fernandez. The risks for Lulu? Among others, to contract a staphylococcus or a streptococcus, a sepsis, a local abscess or an infection of the cartilage, otherwise called chondritis. The other complication is of viral origin and is explained in particular by the lack of hygiene of the equipment used by certain professionals. Thus, the piercing device can cause herpes, hepatitis, types B and C and D, but also, in much rarer cases, HIV. The viral risk is real and should absolutely not be taken lightly, insists our specialist. And to specify an unequivocal figure, there is 2.5 times more likely to contract hepatitis B during an earlobe piercing, especially before the baby is 3 months old, when the latter has not been performed by a doctor. Once baby's ears are pierced, the scarring risks are not negligible. It takes 4 weeks for the skin to heal. This is a long time that can cause complications, especially if the child touches the wound with dirty hands, notes the pediatrician. The risks involved? A disharmonious healing, which may require a surgical operation. Obviously complex and restrictive for a small part. For parents who still wish to pierce the earlobes of their little end, precautionary measures must be observed, such as the quality of the chosen place. First of all, it is necessary to verify that there are indeed two distinct spaces in the shop. The place of sale and the room where the professional pierces the ears of the child in order to minimize the risk of infections, explains Arnault Fernandez. On the other hand, it is necessary to ensure that the equipment is sterile, used for the first time, and that the professional has in his possession suitable disinfection equipment. Finally, the days following the piercing, vigilance is required. You have to be very careful about the follow-up of the piercing, warns our pediatrician. In the event of stinging, redness, swelling, pain or discharge, the material must be immediately removed and a specialist should be consulted urgently.